loved one, which I know as Mother Rodney. Amen. We're going to begin with a solo, with the Grant sisters coming forth, followed by a solo by Catherine Grant. The Lord be your strength.
When she raised not only her 8 children, but others' children. I don't know how many, I would say at least 10. And she raised them in the light of Jesus. She raised them to know the Lord. And that God, I know that she has a crown in heaven. So this song, dedicate to her.
Must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight in your face. You were content to let me shine. You always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the glory, but you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I would fly higher than an eagle. You are. Of a pin to go unnoticed. I have it right here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Of course I know the truth. I will be nothing without you. Thank you. You are the wind beneath my wings.
Amen. A hero. We're celebrating the life of a hero. Mother Rodney was a hero for so many people, a rescuer. Praise God for her celebrating her life on today. Amen. At this time, we're going to have scripture readings. We're going to have an Old Testament scripture reading from Maria Warren, which will be followed by the New Testament scripture reading from Vanessa Warren. Let us be praying for each and everyone. Pray for their strength as they come forth.
Friends and everybody, we're here to celebrate Dorothy Mae Rodney, a virtuous woman. I'm bringing my Bible my grandmother gave me years ago, so I'm reading out of my grandmother's Bible of a virtuous woman. Who can find a virtuous wife? For her worth is far above rubies. The heart of her husband safely trusts her. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and willing works with her hands. She is like the merchant ships. She brings her food from afar. She also rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and a portion of her maidservants. She considers a field a buy it. From her profit, she plants vineyards. She grids herself with strength. She grids herself with strength in the strength of her arms. She perceives that her merchandise is good and her lamp does not go out at night. She stretches out her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She extends her hand to the poor. She reaches out her hands to the needy. She reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of snow for her household, for all her household is clothed in scarlet. She makes taperers for herself. Her clothing is fine linen in the gates. Her husband, Cliff, is known in these gates. When he sits among the elders of the land, she makes linen garments, sells them, and she supplies sashes for merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing. Strength and honor is her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom. Again, she opens her mouth with wisdom. and on her tongue it is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household and does not eat bread of illness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband, Cliff, Rodney, also in her praises bar her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is passing. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing. But a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her her fruit of her hand, Lord. Oh my God. Give her her fruit of her hand, Lord. And let her own her work of praise, her in her gates. Amen. I love you, Mimi.
Who shall bring charge against God's elect? Is it God who justifies? Who is here condemn his Christ who died and furthermore is also risen? Who is given at the right hand of God who also makes intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulations or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril, or sword, as it is written. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. For I am persuaded that neither death, glory to God, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, here things present, more things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of Christ, which is in Christ Jesus. So, Mimi, take your rest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take your rest. Because you said the word of God tell us, absent from the body is present with the Lord. So we give you glory this morning. And we sing hallelujah to your name, Jesus. For he is worthy. Oh, yes, God. He is worthy of all the glory and the honor. So, Mimi, I said again, take your rest. Because you are with the Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, we just thank you. Thank you. Thank you that she's in the presence of the Lord. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
Sister Darlene Henderson is coming with the prayer of comfort.
God bless everyone for coming to share this moment of rejoicing for my mom's life. And I know you're saying why she got on all white like she's going to a wedding. I am. And I did. Because we know in the scriptures that we don't go home any kind of way. The groom who's married to us, he lays up for us a place. And he tells us, as our souls are leaving our bodies, he said, come, my servant, enter, my faithful servant, into my rest. She entered and laid up for her as a crown of righteousness. Only the just shall judge. She kept the faith. She had a rough life. One thing everybody can say, she was strong, hey, and she was a warrior. But she loved, and she loved hard. Me and my mom started the journey in this place. Both of us are headstrong. She was a leader. She loved her family. And you know, she's raised me the same way. Sometimes I would get out of place, and I thought I was the mom. And she had to put me back in place. But you know what? We went on a journey here, and we got counseling. We got together. And that journey we went on was with Jesus. And he told me, honor thy mother and thy father, so your life will be strong. I'm telling you, got a mother and a father. I don't care what you went through, what you're going through. Honor them. Love them. Be there for them. And you have to do it with Christ Jesus. And he let me look into her life. And he gave her the grace for her to share it with me. And we would call each other, and all I would do, give scriptures and bless her. Woman of God, you blessed. Woman of God, you're going to get through this. Woman of God, your children are blessed and highly favored. And I'm going to move the curtain and let you know what we prayed and how we prayed. For this God that we serve is real. He's tangible. We can feel him. He gives us mercy and grace when we don't deserve it. Father, I come unto you, God, knowing that you are God and you're the all-living God. There's nobody besides you, God. Oh, Father, when you got ready to take her, you came in the room and you wrecked the place. Hallelujah. Come in this room and wreck it. Everything that we think we know, everything that we're holding in our hearts, oh, wreck it. Tear it up, God, and put a place of love, compassion, understanding. It is by your mercy and grace that you draw us. Oh, be tangible. Oh, fill this room with your glory and your honor, oh God. Touch every child, God. Touch every son and every daughter. Oh God, let us know the God that she served is more than able. More than able to cover us. More than able to hold us up. Oh, more than able to stand in, up in us and cover us and go before us. Hallelujah. And God, if it's all possible, everything is possible, let her reach. Let her stand over the balcony and let her see her praises for a short period of time. In the name of Yeshua, Hamashua, sit on us. We give you all glory and all honor. For this is the God that she served.
Let's give God a praise for her life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank God. Yes, Lord. We thank God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah, God. She was a praiser. Hallelujah. We're talking about a praiser. Hallelujah. We're celebrating the life of a woman of God who was a praiser. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord. How can you celebrate her life without praising God yourself? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He's worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. We thank God. We thank God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We thank God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We thank God. Hallelujah. Thank God. Hallelujah. The life that we're celebrating, you know, hallelujah, was a woman of God. No, she loved the Lord. No, she loved the dance. No, she loved the praise. We come to celebrate her life. We got to set aside what we prefer. Hallelujah. And celebrate the life of Dorothy Rodney. Reverend Dorothy Rodney. Hallelujah. A virtuous woman. A praiser. A worker. A lover. A nurturer. A giver. Hallelujah. We're celebrating her life on today. And we bless the name of the Lord in doing so. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a solo by Derek Grant. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, I wish somebody could just shout to the Lord with the voice of triumph. Come on, to my family, to my cousins, to my aunts and uncles, the grace of the Lord will be your portion. This is one of the last songs we sang. My aunt Donna, I remember she was dancing. I'm gonna try to sing it like my daddy. I'm gonna try to do it. Y'all go ahead like a ship. Come on, we gonna have church today. I don't know about you, but the Lord will make a way somehow. I wish I had a Holy Ghost witness. Y'all pick it up a little bit, y'all. Oh, like a ship that's tossed and driven. When the storm of life is raging and the fury fall on me, Lord, I wonder, oh, what have I done, Lord, to make this race so hard to run? And then I say to my soul, I gotta speak to myself, you better take courage, the Lord will make a way.
Make a way. He will make a way. when you can't find it. I know he'll be your peace late at the midnight hour. Oh, let him be your joy. Let him be your joy. Lord, he'll make the way. Oh, he'll make the way. He'll make the way. Oh, yes, he will. Listen. There's a sweet relief, Bishop, in knowing the Lord will make the way. I want you to just lift your hands if you believe it. That the Lord will make a way somehow. Oh Lord, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh, he will. He will, he will make a way somehow. Thank you, Lord.
Will make a way. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The Lord will make a way. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Even in this, the Lord will make a way. Glory to God. He's going to make a way for you to get through this. He's going to make a way for you to stand even at this time. Glory be to God. He's going to make a way for you to find strength even when you feel weak. He's going to make a way. Oh, yes, he will. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to your own understanding. Amen. We praise God. Amen. For that solo. Bless my heart. Glory be to God. Amen. At this time, we're going to make room for remarks and reflections. Amen. We're going to begin with Brother Clifford Rodney, her dear husband. Amen.
I want to give God all the praise, and the honor, and the glory. And I want to say a foreword. I want to give him all the honor this morning. Yeah. Hallelujah. 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 The greatest praise, yeah. I give it to him if I deserve it. He deserves all the honor and the glory. Yeah. My friend, God so wonderful. He took me through so much stuff. I just got to look to him. And he give me all the answers. I got a strong wife, I can't tell you that. A lady who have faith. A prayer warrior. A prayer warrior. A lady who full of love. Love, love, love. Love, 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 love. Oh man. You got some wonderful kids. All of them is wonderful. Wonderful son, wonderful daughter. Wonderful grandkids, everybody, and a wonderful family. A family who can pray, a family who God put through so much, and he carried them right through. Right through. Sometimes, he never failed. My friend, I got to tell him, heaven is a beautiful place. Filled with glory and grace. Yes. I want to see my Savior's face. Yes. I want to see my Savior's face. Heaven is a wonderful place filled with glory. I thank for everyone who come out today. I just thank God for giving them the strength to wake up this morning. Yes. Wake up everyone this morning and then come out to celebrate. Sister Rodney, yes. I just give him the one who traveled in the plane. Ask God to give them trouble mercy. Give them trouble mercy. And bless the whole family. Bless the church family. Everyone in here. Bless all their family. For all of us need prayer. All of us need guidance. Guidance. You're so much going on in this world, man. I can't tell anyone if they don't know God. Please go to him. Go to him and repent. For there's so much going on in this world. This world is not our home. Heaven is the heart of our home. Try and make it. Make it. I try my best. The best I can. The best I can. Don't give up. You can make it. But heaven is a wonderful place. Filled with glory and grace. With glory and grace. Yes. With glory and grace. Yes. Grace. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Yeah, thank you. Yes. Yeah.
My mother. Oh, how did I love her? We would be on the phone for 2 hours talking because she was my best friend. Not just my mother. Ooh. Mommy, I love you. You know I love you. And I know you loved all your kids. These are tears of joy. We all must take this journey. Yes. And she took it with courage. Yes. And I was by her side. Yes. And my mother didn't suffer. Yes. I made sure she did. I gave you all the healing hands you gave me when I was a baby. I put them on you when you were going home. I was able to return the favor. You with joy, not sadness. Every time I think of you, I'm going to rejoice in the love you gave me and my siblings and your husband and your adopted children. You were just so caring to everyone. Yes. And one thing about children, man, you would not let anyone mistreat a child. Oh, my dear, am I going to miss you? But it's going to be joy every time I think of you, my darling. This is not goodbye. And I shall see you again, my love. I'm done.
Amen. We have remarks and reflections that are coming from the immediate family, which is specifically Mother Rodney's children. And we're going to begin with her oldest son, Ahmed Sadiq. God bless you, sir.
Hello, everyone. I'm not going to be up here very long because I know a lot of people want to speak. But being the firstborn, me and my mother 18 years apart, so I'm gonna begin at five years old. She taught me about civil rights then. I'm an activist now, but I got it from her then. I didn't understand it, where it came from, but she would tell me, and she had your undivided attention because she would do it like this. Tenzi, she called me Tenzi. Look at me, boy. This is what I want you to do. And whatever that was, she had my undivided attention. And she showed me how to stand up for myself when I was little. I can remember this, 5 years old, an incident that occurred. And it was a young man. This ain't no war story. I'm just telling you how I became involved in civil rights. I said, well, he's trying to ride my bike every day, and I didn't tell her nothing. And she said, okay. She said, who it is. I said, it's the big boy. I stressed that. It's the big one. He's real big. So she said, well, don't worry about that. This is what you do. She didn't teach us to be violent or fight. She taught us how to defend ourselves physically and mentally and spiritually, how to defend yourself. So you go back outside. I'm looking for her to come with me, but she wasn't coming. So I went back outside. She told me what to do. I ain't gonna get into details, but I did exactly that. And all I heard was a lot of screaming after that. Some people was pulling both my legs and they couldn't see my face. But I heard a couple of women say, oh Lord, that's Dot Boy. So here's another problem. Now they're trying to get me off the boy and they find out who the boy is. That's Dot Child. So they got him loose and everything. He went on home. And then when they stood there to debate what we gonna do. So they went on home. They didn't mess with Don. So when I got back inside the next day, I felt so good. Because she said, I don't care how big it is, how big your problem is, no matter how big it is, you can face it, son. This woman had faith. When I said faith, she had faith and she backed it up with action. It wasn't no talk. It's time to do. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go take care of business. So my mother raised us in a way, a nurturing way. And she was everything. She was kind and soft, and she could be stern and firm at the same time. Whatever the occasion called for, she was able to deal with it. And all of us are individual personalities. She was able to deal with each personality. She knew me, she knew my brother, she knew all of us. And I just want to end by saying, I love my mother for her spirit, her faith, her, first of all, she's the prayerest woman I ever seen. She used to pray for 25, 30 minutes. I'd be like, when is, but then she'll say something, and Lord Tenzi. So when she said my name, I kind of perked up a little bit. And do you know, when she prayed, we knew what to do as siblings. Everybody quiet. You can't hit a pin drop. And we would sit there, and some of everybody's name would come up. You don't know who gonna come up. But she had that, what she would, and my son Tenzi, look after. He going through something. Pray on, Mom, pray. But that's the kind of mother we have. You know, her spirit will always be with us, always be in my heart, because our loved ones never die. The earthly body is going back to where it came from. But the other part, see, one can't go while the other one go. See, we come from two places. One of us come from the earth, and the other part of us come from this God who gave it. So let's keep that spirit alive. Long as we cherish our loved ones and those memories, they always alive. And I just want to say, God bless my siblings. I love y'all. I love y'all dearly. And I'm going to just end with that, okay? Thank you very much.
Hello, family. Hello, friends. I first want to ask God to forgive me of my trespassing and those who trespass against me. I want to get Jehovah the praise and the glory, and his son, Yeshua, who was bruised for our iniquities, wounded for our transgressions, chastised for our peace. He wore the crown of thorns that we may have the crown of glory in heaven and on earth. And through his stripes we are healed, and we have life, life more abundantly. When he ascended, he did not leave us alone. He left us power from the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gave us power and might and attributes of power and might, of love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, meekness, and temperance. I come to you on five viewpoints of my mother, her accomplishments. Most of us know her accomplishments. I'm not going to get in too deep because I have to move on decent in order. Her stories and her philosophies. She had stories and philosophy for every individual that she talked to. She used the atmosphere that was around her to communicate with you. The third point of view is who she was, her personality and character. Whoever came in contact with her knew her personality and her character. Fourth point of view, your relationship that we each had with her individually. We all had a relationship with her. The fifth point of view is what she meant to us. And the influence she left on us. The influence that she left on me out of everything, and I fought and stretched against it, was the Word of God. She left the Word of God imprinted in my mind and in my heart. I fall short. Quite a few times I fall short. But the seed she planted up in me always came to the surface. And this is what she told me 40 years ago. She said, Red, she called me Red. She said, what do you have in your hand? I said, what do you mean, Mom? She said, what do you have in your hand? And she took me to a scripture in Ecclesiastes 9 and 10. And it read as thus, whatsoever thy hand find to do, do it with thy might. For there is no activity, no knowledge, no wisdom, no work in the grave where we are going. And I began to study the scriptures, and I found scriptures to refer to this scripture in Psalms 115, 17. The dead do not praise the Lord, and neither do those that goes down into silence. Psalms 6 and 5. The dead has no remembrance of thee, and they give you no thanks. These are the scripture that was embranded on my heart. I said, Mom, what do you mean? What do I have in my hand? Baby, what do you have in your heart? Yes. Whatever your heart finds to do, do it with thy might. Don't do anything haphazardly. Yes. Okay. Don't do anything mediocrity. And I just want to sum this up with a story that we all know, even heard it in Sunday school, watched it on television. the Ten Commandments. When God called Moses to deliver his word, and Moses entered the mountain, the Mount Sinai, and he asked Moses, "Moses, what is that that you have in your hand?" Moses said, "That rod, that staff that Pharaoh gave me to rule over the scorpions and the snakes in the desert." He said, "I want you to take that same rod and that same staff to go down into Egypt and command Pharaoh to let those people go." And Mom brought this scripture up to me. This is her staff, her rod, her scepter, her baton that hanged in our house between two pillars in the entrance of the house. This is a declaration from the Old Testament of God himself. This was a weapon that God gave Moses to bring all the plagues into Egypt. And when Pharaoh chased us after him, Moses used the rod, fire by day, and smoke a pillar by night, the same rod he used to open the sea, the same rod he used to bring water from the desert, the same rod he used to bring manna and quail from heaven. And she asked me, "Red, what do you have in your hand?" He said, "Your hands are like gold, but your heart is like platinum." She always took every individual. She was able to see the seed of core of goodness in a person to where they would manifest it and become a more complete person. Jesus was ready to be ascended into heaven. He had did all his good works and labor and suffered. And after being crucified on the cross, he was getting ready to be ascended to his Father. And the disciples did not want him to go. They said, "Lord, please don't leave us alone." He said, "I have trained you, I taught you to be disciples, to go into the highways and the byways and compel the people to come in." He said, "If I don't go, I can't bring you the power from on high. If I don't go, you won't receive the power." He taught them, he trained them, but he didn't do this in vain. He didn't suffer in vain. He didn't teach them in vain to leave and have them scattered like sheep. He left them power from on high that they would go out and do the same thing he did. Create miracles. Teach. My mother was a disciple of Jehovah in the name of Yeshua. She built churches. She was an evangelist, a missionary, a minister. Most of all, she was a humanitarian of the community. She would walk and everybody knew her and called her blessed. But my mother did not leave us. She trained us. She taught us to be unified as a family. This rod that I'm holding and the rod that my big brother is holding, she had to go. But she still left us with power. She didn't leave us unshepherded to be scattered like sheep after she left. My big brother looked after us when we was young. 10 years old, My mother was a single mother. She would go to work. She would take care of us. But she left my brother in charge. He cooked for us. He made sure that we did our daily duties. Make sure they don't leave the yard. And when something went wrong, she didn't come to us. She went to him. I left you in charge. As of now, she left. She's gone. But she did not leave not preparing us for someone to shepherd over us. My big brother has been trained for this. All glory go to my mother that walked in the three heavens and labored. She knew what she was doing. She stored up treasures on earth to be put into heaven. She has crowns from her good deeds and her good works to present to God, saying, glory, 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 hallelujah. My big brother, this rod, the staff that symbolizes authority, power, guidance, I pass it on to you. And each one of my siblings can say that my brother is a very loving and compassionate individual. And this is no job that he cannot do. To make sure that this family stay unified. And the baton that my mother passed to him, it won't be dropped. This race stays consistent. This family stays consistent. This family stays strong. In the name of Yeshua.
Love is? Love is? Love is? I'm going to keep this short for the sake of time. I'm going to keep it together. I'm going to keep it short. It's harder than I thought it was. I don't think I can do this. So what I'm going to do, first of all, thank you all for coming out to celebrate my mother, Dorothy Rodney. I think my siblings did a great job in kind of sharing you guys a little insight on where we're from, who she is, and how we got here. It's been a long journey for all of us, and there's no I in any of what I'm saying. And please, it's we and us, right? She taught us how, when it's all said and done, I want you guys to respect me, respect my decisions, and you, I know I raised, I know my children. There may be some tough roads ahead, but I know at the end that you guys are going to be united. And I want to share something that's somewhat intimate to me. And we call her affectionately Mommy. We were there. We were there. We were there in the end. We were there before you closed your eyes as one uniform family. You heard our prayers. You heard our love. You saw, and you smiled. And we know you did, because after we prayed over you, you opened your eyes. And you said, Johnny Guy, good job. This is not about me. This is about us. This is about Mommy. She's in a better place. She's home. She's looking down at me right now. You guys got to know something. The hugs. I got on my knees every time I went over to my mom's house. I got on my knees, and I hugged her, and I heard a heartbeat. I heard a heartbeat, and I said, deep down in there, Mommy, I know you're there. Squeeze my hand. And she did. She did. So I'm just going to leave you guys on this note. I love you. If you know Mommy, I love you. I love you. I love you.
Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. Is this on? Is it on? Okay, no. No, it's not. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. All right. Everyone in here knew Mommy, which I used to always call her Mother Rodney. But everyone has a story about her, and everyone felt the love, the compassion that she had for everyone. Whatever you needed, if you were hungry, she fed you. If you needed some place to sleep, she gave you a bed and some nice 100% cotton sheets. You know, she always, if you left, you left with a care package. That was her. And she's going to call you, baby, are you okay? You know what to do. You may bend, but you'll never break. Stand up. Stand up for yourself. We always say that Mommy, Mother Rodney, was the Harriet Tubman of this family. She showed us what freedom was, starting here, here, and then we put it into practical application. That's who she was. That was Mommy. So this is Suge. She called her, this is my little baby who sings for me. But at the end of the day, I just want to leave you guys with this, that Mommy was a warrior, and she still lives because now we're fighting. We're fighting the fight that she handed down to us, not only for us, but for our children, our grandchildren. We have to continue to let them know that in order to succeed and experience what freedom is, you have to first be free. In order to teach, you must first be taught. And that's what she did for us. So I'm gonna let my granddaughter do this. This is what mommy would be saying right now. Stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. For across the river, do you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer. I'm gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones.
Early in the morning, before the sun begins to shine, gonna start moving towards that separating line. I'm wading through muddy waters. You know I got a made up mind. And I don't mind if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I'll fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me.
Together we are going to a brand new home. For across the river, do you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer. I'm gonna keep on. Stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a better home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer. I'm gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones.
Amen. Amen. Stand up. Hallelujah. Amen. Will there be any more remarks from the children of Mother Dorothy Rodney? Amen. We have her siblings. We want to make time for her brothers and sisters for their remarks. Amen. You may come up now.
Church, say amen. Somebody say amen. This is a Homegoing celebration. Amen. To God be the glory for the great things he have done. Amen. We can thank God for her life because she lived a life. Amen. A life that was pleasing unto Christ. Amen. And I remember when she came down to Texas to visit her daughter, who is my wife, Darlene. And I heard her pray this prayer. And she said, to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. And this was 3 years ago. Amen. And that caught on to me. And I said, you know what? She ready. She ready. She ready. She ready. Amen. Now the question is, are you ready? Are you ready? We can be with her again, but we have to be ready. Amen. And God went to prepare a place for us that where he's at, then we may be also. Amen. He done paid the price. And I got to celebrate her life because she was not only a mother-in-law to me, but she was a friend. Amen. And love is what? Is what? Love is what? Say what? Say what? Love is what love does. Amen. And you tell Dot, say, Dot, I love you. And what would she say? I love you more. Amen. And that's all she was. She was nothing but love. And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, whatsoever, believeth in him shall not perish, but shall have what? Everlasting life. She received it in the name of Jesus. And we can praise them. We can praise them this day and celebrate her homegoing this day in the name of Jesus. Amen. Bless you. Bless you, family. Love you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
Church. She said, John, yes, I want you to sing that song for me. Say, I got to preach. Lord, I want you to help me. Amen. Me and sis go back a long ways. We had some good days and we had some bad days. And she used to be, everything they said, that is true. No sooner mama would walk out the house, she said, Dot, I want you to take care of now. No, before she can get out the door, good. All right, let's clean this house. And you go out there and get me a switch. My God, mama ain't got off the step yet. She wore the whip. Amen, praise God. That's the type of person she was. I'm not saying because she's my sister, she was a true loving lady. She just loved. Yes, yes. She just knew how to love, y'all. Yes. And she know how to put you in place. She didn't go around, you know, if she sees something wasn't right, She let you know it's up to you to get upset at it. That's your problem. Because she going on home, going down on her knees, and talk to the Lord about it. I used to go to her with some serious problems. She said, John, it's going to be all right. Let's pray. I said, I ain't coming and pray. I thought you were going to help me out a little bit. Praise God. That's the type of person my sister was. There's no need for me to try to stand up here and could cook. Yes. Oh, man, she yes. could cook how to cook. Yes. She could take nothing and make something out yes. of it. She knew how to do that. You get an old piece of tough beef. She said, let's give me a few minutes with it. She work around in there and do something, whatever she be doing. Y'all come on and eat now. And my God, when you eat, you ate something.
Yes.
You can know when you left.
Yes. Yeah.
Sister Grant's house. Sister Grant, she can cook too. Yes. But when you left Sister Rodney.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. You know you had eight.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. One thing about it is, I used to go from church and I go by there. First time she said, did you eat yet? That's the way she was. We had a beautiful sister. And I love you. She asked me to, they asked me to do the you. I said, are you crazy? You people be had to bring her, cast it up there for me. I said, no. You go to her pastor.
Yes.
And you tell him, amen, praise God. And I see, said, praise God, thank God. We love you.
Yes.
We love you, sister. We love you, brother. Bishop, we thank God for you being here with us, and that's enough for me, because I could go on. Whoa, Lord, I want you to help me.
Family and speak because I'm just like that. But it was harder for me to sit back there in my seat and don't get up and share something about my oldest sister. See, she wasn't just an older sister. She was a second mother to us. Praise God. As I can, first of all, I remember this story when she told me, Mildred, you was about 2 years old, and she was about 11. And I got a big safety pin, a big pin stuck in my throat, and I was choking and crying. And she was the only, you know, the mama that wasn't home. She said I had to reach my hand down in your throat and pull out that pin. She said blood and everything came up, but I got it out. And I knew that if she hadn't did that, I wouldn't be here today. So she's always been there for us. You know, she truly, I say she was a second mama to us. She made our clothes. She taught us, mom and daddy didn't have such an education. She taught us how to read and write. She even taught us how to sing. The first song to get up in the church and sing. You can do it. Children, you know how she taught the children. She never stopped it. Children coming, she never stopped. She always loved her children. Well, she was like that all of my life and all of her life. She truly had the biggest heart than anybody know. The heart that spreads out and touch and put action to her word. Whatever she say, that's what she did. If she wasn't going to do it, she didn't bother to say it. She would like it. I didn't say how strong, you know. There would never be another Dot. Dot May, as we used to call her, Dot May. Instead of, we called Dot May as much as we called Mama. Because she was always there. And then she came off to North. And she came back and got her family. And we all came, you know, we all came up here because of Dar May. And I can say she never stopped reaching out to people. give her best, you know, just, she always gave her best. She really had. She's like, if I can do it, I'm going to do it with everything I got. Love is what love does. She's one person that I know. Leave that alone. She always put action to her words. And you know, so many times when I was down, going through things, we get on the phone and we talk. She like, Mildred, you can say just what I need to encourage me. And I can, and I do the same thing. It was just a connection we had. So I thank God for that. Even when she couldn't talk, when she stopped saying anything, just looking. One day I told her, I want to know if you know what I'm talking about, sweetie. She like, she just looked at me like, why wouldn't I, you know? And I told her, you write down whatever you want on this paper. She wrote down her name, her husband's name, no, her name and my name, sister and mama. And children, those are the words she wrote. And she put lines. But anyway, I was just praising God because I knew I was communicating. We was communicating together. And I just thank God for her. And I thank God, I want to say especially for her husband, how he took care of his wife. He ministered to her. He was always there when I came. You know, just right there with her. I never came and he wasn't there. And she used to talk. He's a good man, Mildred. I got a good husband when she could talk. And he proved it, how he stuck with her when she needed him the most. And I just thank God for that. I thank God for all the children that she raised up, great daughters and sons. That I know she loved her children, and I know they love their mom. And I know she's in glory looking down now. And like you say, I hear so many say, she want them, regardless to others or whatever, come together and stay together and grow there. Don't let the enemy have no place to do this separation thing. So I love you, family. And I know my sister is resting in the Lord. I know she's resting, so I thank God for that. That I thank God that I was able, brave enough to get up here to share this. God bless you.
Amen. Just before the siblings proceed with their remarks, certainly we do want to hear everything that you have to say. But in the interest of time, I've been given instructions. Let us all limit it to 2 minutes. Amen.
Thank you. Well, my sister Dot, I mean, everything that I've heard in here today describes her life in detail. I mean, it's hard to add more to that. All I can say that Dot has been a source of knowledge for me. I remember times I would just stop by there just to get her knowledge. She'll sit down and talk to me. She said, well, Skeeter, look at it this way. It could have something to do with my job or personal problem I had or anything like that. I could go there and I would come in there, and as soon as I knock on the door, she said, yeah, boy, go on in the kitchen. There's a pot of whatever on. There's a pot of greens in there, so go on and get you something. So I just go straight to the kitchen to get a pot because she could cook. But, you know, she was a woman that, you know, cared. She was open. She was had a lot of wisdom, and I just can't think of the words to say. She was everything. She was everything. Thank you.
My sister Dot, everything that's been said about her today is everything. And it's everything was love. She was a very, very loved and respected person. And I just she knew that I was one of the sisters of few words. I didn't have too much to say, but I would look back and observe. But I just want to sing this one verse. I want the whole world to know I'm just another soldier, hey, going home. Oh, when you hear of my home going, don't worry about me. Oh, when you hear of my home going, going to be quick, even quicker than hers, because we already know what is in our heart and how we felt, and I have felt but my big sister. And everybody know I'm a choir, and I can do that right there. But I love my sister so much, and always been, love is what love does. And, you know, I spent time with her, and I'll go over there some days in some cut-off shorts, jean, toe up, she'll look at me from head to bottom. But I love her, and I love her, and everybody know what to say. Mommy will say, y'all better get up there. I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I went to go see my grandmother yesterday. And oh, she looks so good. You know? She taught us all how to love each other and be there for one another. And this is why I'll be up here with my cousins, because you know I love y'all. And she would just want us to be together. So I need us to all get right. Yeah. Mommy, I love you so much, baby. I love you so much. I love you so much. Is she good now? She up there. Yeah. I just thank y'all so much.
Okay, just one thing real quick. I just want to say what Mimi taught us. Her children, her grandchildren, her nieces, nephews, friends, family, everybody. I love you more. Love is what love does. Love is what love does when you just take unconditional love and put your love to the side, your struggle to the side, to make sure your family is good, because that's what love does. When you got all these kids running around your house, from the top to the bottom, I don't even know how many it was of. But we had clothes, food, that spaghetti soup pot filled to the top before she left for work. It lasted all night, because that's what love does, to make sure them kids ate. Love is what love does when you take somebody you don't even know and bring them in your home and bless them with the love they might not ever had in their life, because that's what love does. Okay? Love is bringing everybody together. Everybody together. And show that heart through cooking, through laughter, anything, because that's what love does. But most of all, I'm going to say this about, and I never used to call her Mimi. I'm sorry. I couldn't do it. That was Grandma. That's Grandma, so it took years for me to call her Mimi. But what she taught us most of is love. The last word she uttered in her home that I was blessed to witness was love. With love, that was her last word out of her mouth, was love. And to be there to witness that last word was love. So the wisdom she gave us, the knowledge she gave us, because that's what love does. Because Mimi's legacy is going to go on, because that's what love does. Amen.
Amen. We thank God for the remarks coming from the family. Oh, I'm sorry. We have another.
Yeah, I hear Mommy telling me to get up too. yes, Mommy was, she was beautiful. She was outspoken. She was abrasive, unapologetically opinionated.
She was spicy. Puerto Ricans might say, mucho caliente. That was her. I remember when she was moving to Texas and the family threw her a going away party. And everybody got up there and they were talking about her. And I specifically remember Lamar, her brother, speaking and telling stories about how she would protect him from the bullies at school and how she was so strong. And everything they said, I thought, had a light bulb moment. It was like, that's me. My husband married his mother. So we took this journey with Mimi. She taught me how to make stuffing. I make a really good stuffing because of her. She taught me how to make sweet potato pie. Now I know that came through Mama, yeah. So that makes it extra special. She and I, we developed not just a mother-in-law, daughter-in-law relationship, it was a friendship, a sisterhood. I would come there, Mimi had her own separate chair. She would get out of her chair, go make me a cup of coffee. She made a delicious cup of coffee. It was almost like a dessert, a liquid dessert. And she would come and sit right next to me on the other couch and we would talk. We all know that dementia is this horrible, horrible disease. And each day it steals more and more and more until you're unrecognizable. You're no longer there. And about 2 years ago, she said, I want to die. A year later, when she couldn't speak, she wrote it down, I want to die. But God's timing is always perfect, because when her children's hearts were changed, and they all agreed to lay their weapons down and come together, God then took her home. Now, love is what love does. It could be a cliche, but if we take and put those actions behind the words, then she lives. And I know that we all have strong personalities. We're very much opinionated. We're all a lot like Mimi, but in the end, it was all about love. Love has to rule the day. God is love. Let's let love live. And I just want to say, when I used to go see her, while she used to call me sometimes when I retired, and we talk on the phone, and then as this thing progressed, I would go over and sit with her. And every time we would chat, I'd sing the song. I sang it one time, and every time after that, I had to sing it. And just a little snippet of it. I pray for you. You pray for me. We're all a part of God's body. It is His will that every need be supplied. You are important to me. I need you to survive. God bless y'all.
Amen. Amen. Is there another comment of remarks? Okay, 1 minute, please.
I greet you in the name of Jesus. And I have to get up here and honor this woman. She's the strongest, the most amazing woman that I've ever known. And if it was not for her, if it was not for her, my daughter Maria would be somewhere else. because the state of New Jersey wanted to take her from me. And she had to become my foster mother. So without this woman here, my family, this whole world, and some that are missing would not be here and would not be a part of this amazing family. And I thank you for allowing me in when you didn't have to. And I thank her, because without her, none of this is possible. And I thank you.
Amen. Amen. At this time, Brother Johnny Guy is coming to read the obituary. We also had cards and resolutions coming from Maria Warren. We understand in the interest of time, she would not be able to get to all the prayers and all the wishes for your strength. We will acknowledge that at a later time. Amen.
Reverend Dorothy Rodney, affectionately known to her children and grandchildren as Mimi, was born August 25th, 1937, to the parents of Percy Lewis and Rosa Grant, stepfather Eddie Roy, in Sparta, Georgia. She attended Greensboro High School there. Dorothy was married to the late John Warren, and to the union, 8 children were born. She moved to New Jersey in 1959. In 1987, she remarried to Clifford Rodney. In this union, she adopted Mahala Rodney and became the foster parents to several children, Sean, Aaron, Kasha, Novik, Eddie, and many others. She was blessed like that, right? Reverend Rodney worked at Pine Brook Care Center as a nurse's aide until she retired in the late 80s. Reverend Rodney was a virtuous woman of God. She became a member of Bethlehem Prayer House under the leadership of the late pastor R.L. Jennings. She had later attended Second Baptist Church in Freel, now known as New Beginnings. Mother Rodney, as she was affectionately called by most, was truly a child of God. She became an integral part of the church community and was well known for ministry work. But the most joy came from her work at Faith Tabernacle Church in Freehold. Mother Rodney was involved in many areas of the church and lived her life to influence and affect the lives of all who met her. She worked tirelessly teaching, mentoring, guiding young and old. She touched so many lives in her time here. Mother Rodney was passionate about studying the Bible and worked fervently in several Christian ministries. Mother Rodney was a traditionalist. Thanksgiving at the Rodney home was a sight to behold. If you knew Mother Rodney, you knew how great a cook she was. Best stuffing you ever had. And please don't mention the sweet potato pie. She enjoyed setting the table and having as many family members over as possible. Mother Rodney was a matriarch in every sense of the word. Mother Rodney was predeceased by her parents, Rosa Grant, Eddie Roy, sister, Minister Doretha Rodney, Minister Shirley Warren, brother, Pastor Otis Grant Jennings, Pastor Dennis Grant's son, Glenn Warren, grandson, Wally Warren. She leaves to treasure in her memories her devoted husband, Clifford Rodney, son and daughters, Ahmed Sadiq, his wife, sorry about the misspelling, Serena, Ennis Warren, Johnny Guy Warren, wife Beulah, Darlene Henderson, husband Jose, Khadijah Muhammad, husband Jahid, Vanessa Warren, Marion Taylor, husband Gerard, Mahala, Sunshine Rodney. She also survived by brothers and sisters, John Grant, wife Lucy, Lamar Grant, wife Linda, Leon Grant, Mildred Lawrence, Marion Grant, husband Johnny, Rosa Grant Smith, Catherine Grant, Noda Grant Wilson, Charmin Barksdale, husband Terrence. In addition, she leaves behind many grandchildren and a host of nieces, nephews, cousins, relatives, and friends. Mommy, this is for me. You will always be in my heart forever. Love is.
Amen. Amen. Beautiful obituary. Amen. As we mentioned, we're going to acknowledge the cards, resolutions, and all of your sentiments at a later date. Please pardon us in the interest of time. Amen. It's time for the Word of God. Pastor Steve McCray, her pastor, is coming. Amen. But before he comes, amen, I know I would not be able to get away with this. She loved to hear Daniel Grant. So we're going to have a brief selection by Daniel Grant, and then Pastor Steve will be before you. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Family, I love you. We love you. We're here for you. Pick up the phone, call anytime. Amen. I believe y'all know this song. I know me and Daddy used to do a little bit of call response. And I can hear his voice in my head right now. It says, "Say Playboy." Can I hear y'all say Playboy? He used to do. And I will come back. He would say, boy, take it away. We'll be right back.
Come on, put those hands together. Come on, put those hands together. Let's give God a praise. Let's give him a praise. How many know he's worthy to be praised? He's worthy to be praised. The Lord to walk with us. Walk with me, Lord. Gracious Heavenly Father, we just thank you, Lord. We praise you. We give you the honor and the glory. This is the day you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Look over your manservant right now as I bring forth this word right now. Touch me as I stand and declare your gospel right now. Hide me behind the cross this afternoon. Anoint, touch this old stuttering tongue right now, Lord. Give me strength when strength is needed. Send deliverance through the word right now, Lord. Touch. Let somebody come to you right now. What must I do to be saved right now? Through the word. And Lord, we just give your name the praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray and give you thanks. Let us all say amen. Amen. I just want to give honor to God who's the head of my life. Thank God for the pastor, the shepherd of this church, a pastor, my brother in the gospel, Pastor Dr. Andre McGuire. I thank God for Pastor Pierce Dassey up there. God bless you. You, sir. Thank God for our Bishop Reuben, our Minister Henderson. Thank God for all the pastors. I see Pastor Jennings. God bless you, sir. God bless you. Pastor Grant. God bless you, sir. Anybody else that I have missed, I give you honor. Thank God for my wife, Dr. LaTanya McRae. God bless her. And to this family, God bless you. God bless you. We are yet praying. We are yet praying for this family. I've been knowing this family all my life. God bless you. And thank God I am Red and Johnny God, a little older than me. But I came along with Lisa. And me and Lisa, we all went to school together, grade school. Brian Crooms and Brian Crooms. I see Lisa Thorpe. We all went to school together, came up right here in Freehold. But this is a beautiful family. This is a beautiful family. Thank God for her husband. Thank God. I salute you, Brother Rodney. I salute you, sir. God bless you. And I tell you, took care of your wife. I witnessed it. I witnessed it. Myself, you took care. A couple of weeks ago, me and Dr. McRae stopped by to see Mother Rodney. And I tell you, at one time, I didn't think she couldn't get out the bed. But she came downstairs. And we had prayer. And you can still feel the anointing. And I tell you, she was an awesome woman of God. I know I got to get quickly. But I thank God for meeting this woman of God and God sending her our way. I can remember years ago, she would come to Faith Tabernacle and she would visit. She didn't join the church at that time. My father, the late Pastor James McRae, was pastoring at that time. And Mother Rodney would come to the church and sit back there in the back, and she would visit, and she would have remarks to say. But many years later, I can remember me and Dr. McRae were on vacation, and Mother Rodney came through the church. She testified, and she said that the Lord spoke to her and said that she wanted to become a member of Faith Tabernacle. We were on vacation at that time, and the saints was rejoicing. And a couple of the saints called me up and said, Pastor, we got a surprise for you when you get back from vacation. Mother Rodney join the church that next Sunday. And she didn't only join by herself, her husband, her grandchildren, her son, Glenn, they all became members of Faith Tabernacle. Now, do the time. Give me 10 minutes. Give me 10 minutes, because this lady already preached her funeral. She lived it. So give me 10 minutes. Philippians, the first chapter. When you have it, say amen. Philippians, the first chapter, starting from the 21st to the 26th verse. I'll be reading from the New King James Version. I will be reading from 21st verse says, for to me to live is Christ, to die is gain. But if I live on in the flesh, this will mean fruit from my labor. Yet what shall I choose? And I cannot tell, for I am hard pressed between the two, having desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. Nevertheless, to remain in the flesh is more needful for you. And being confident of this, I know that I shall remain and continue with you all for your progress and joy of faith, that your rejoicing for me may be more abundant in Jesus Christ by my coming to you again. The 21st verse states, for to me to live is Christ and to die is to gain. Look at your neighbor real quickly. Say, neighbor, the best is yet to come. There are many amazing things yet to be experienced by those who live this life, receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. For those who are born again through repentance and faith in Him, there are better days ahead. The best is yet to come. And I can remember that old saying, you ain't seen nothing yet. And has been set that a believer in Christ enjoys the best of two worlds. This world, this that we are still living in the next world of life after death, eternal life. Don't let anybody fool you. This physical life that we now enjoy is not all. In the afterworld, existent after death, also known as the afterlife. We shall never fully understand or accept death entirely. But the Bible declares that God will not have us ignorant concerning those who sleep in the Lord. Even though it is a separation and a final going, never to return to this world again. Remember, it is the death of the body, not the death of the soul. Death is not the destruction of the individual. They are merely absent from the body. For the believer, it means they are present with the Lord. For the unbeliever, in hell, he will lift up his eyes. Consider what this means to the believer. The greatest experience possible for a man or a woman is to become one with God. This begins with conversion, inviting Jesus Christ into your life to forgive sins and save the soul. This is what happens when one becomes a Christian. I'm talking about the best of the world now that we are living in. This is the best of the world when you receive Christ in your life. To have an awareness of God's spirit dwelling within you. to have the insurance of your sins forgiven, to serve the Lord, to be received unto a warm church family, and to have a home in heaven waiting for you. The best of the world that we're living in when you receive Jesus Christ in your life. This is all these things that the deceased have. For Paul, I'm about coming in now. For Paul, however, to live meant to tell others about Christ, going from one place to another while he was on this earth. Paul would point others to Jesus Christ. Paul spoke out boldly, getting beaten, put in jail, among other things. Paul could confidently say that dying would be even better than living, because in death he would be removed from worldly troubles. He would see Christ. Paul was totally committed to Christ, giving his life as a sacrifice to God. To gain, as Paul said, means to obtain or secure something desired, favorable, or profitable. Now, I just got finished letting you know about these earthly things that we have gained when you receive Jesus Christ. And I'm coming in now. I'm coming in for the time. But I want to talk about the best is yet to come. When you leave this earth, the things that we are going to have, the best is yet to come. Realize this after you have went on with the Lord, you ain't seen nothing yet. For those that have gone through trials and sickness, death is a release to the soul, freeing it from a tired, worn, or diseased body. The best is yet to come. In death, one enjoys the presence of the Lord in a different way, way beyond how they experience him here on earth. The best is yet to come. You will be able to see the loved ones that went on to be with the Lord before you did. The best is yet to come. You will receive an immortal body, free from the physical limitations and the effects of sin. No more sickness, no more pain, no more sorrow. The best is yet to come. A new name, the best is yet to come. A new home, the best is yet to come. A new society, composed of the believers of all ages, the best is yet to come. You get to see in history, saints, family, and loved ones who went on before you. The best is yet to come. I'm here to encourage the church today. The best is yet to come. Mother Rodney is rejoicing right now. Mother Rodney is happy right now. And I thought about Wally. She's up there with her grandson, Wally. And I thought about Pastor Otis Jennings. She's up there with her brother right now. I'm here to tell you, while we are living, because we know that we are living right, God, we will see God once again and realize this, the best is yet to come. You may stand. I want to quickly. Anybody that's not saved, you're not saved. Put your hand up. Put your hand up. You have not received Jesus Christ in your life. Put your hand up. Put your hand up. Put your hand up. I just want to make a quick altar call real quickly. If you're not saved, you're not saved. Put your hand up. That's okay. Yes. Dr. McCray, would you pray?
Father, we thank you and we give you praise on today. Thank you for the word that came forth, which was an example of the life of Mother Rodney, one that would speak boldly for Christ, oh God. Thank you, Lord, for the seeds that were planted in our lives, oh God. Thank you how you used her, oh God, to help us through, Thank you for those seeds that were planted that are sprouting up now. Father, the word that was preached, the best is yet to come. Glory be to God. Let it sprout up now to your glory, oh God. Every seed that was planted, let it find strength and grow and stretch tall and wide in the family, oh God. Reaching out to the rest of this world, just like Mother Rodney did. Touch the family now and comfort them, oh God, as they walk in her footsteps, oh God. And let the oil of her anointing rest upon them now in the name of Jesus Christ, oh God. Young and old, oh God, let them be used by you to your glory as they walk in their mother's footsteps, their grandmother, their auntie, their sister. Oh God, bless and comfort and be glorified with the life that she lived. Let her works speak for themselves, oh God. For the best is yet to come, not only for her, but for we that were able to sit under her. We thank you, Father, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, let us say amen. Let's say amen again. If you believe it, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Benediction is on the program. And then after the benediction, be in the hands of the mortician.
The best is yet to come. We want to thank Pastor McGuire for his hospitality and the congregation of his pulpit. My mom is living, and the best that has came to her, the best is yet to come. Whatsoever our hands find to do, let us do it with our might. For there is no activity, no work, no knowledge in the grave. For those that have a companion, enjoy their company. Be merciful. Be forgiving. Live life fully with your companion. Those that have friends, continue to be a good friend, to be forgiving. As we leave this place, this fellowship that we commune and broke bread together, the enemy outside this place, he walks around like a roaring lion, seeking what he may devour, to steal and take your joy. So I ask you to be on guard and protect what you just received like a soldier on a wall. Guard your heart with all custodians with strength and might. May you go forward. May blessings fall upon your finances. May joy fall upon your relationships. May God reveal troubled waters before you. May your heart be full with the Holy Spirit. For we have to walk with the full armor of God. And I ask you that you live in prosperity and love, because love is what love does. And be steadfast in this walk that we walk, because the prize is not given to the swift nor the strong, but those that endure to the end. That God may say, my faithful servant. Until we meet again, maybe tomorrow, maybe in heaven, may love and joy be with you all the days of your life. In Yeshua's name.